This evening in the studio we have Pandit Nikhil Banerjee, one of India's two great sitarists. Pandit Banerjee is performing a concert next Saturday evening at the Berkeley Little Theatre, commencing at 8:30, and accompanied on the tabla by Pandit Mahapurush Mishra. Pandit Banerjee has taught in the United States for the last two summers at the American Society for Eastern Arts Summer School, and has toured many of the colleges and universities in the United States. And he has also recently completed a tour of Australia and Fiji. Pandit Banerjee this evening will discuss some of the more involved aspects of the raga system, the note and melodic basis for Indian music. Pandit Banerjee, there are many ragas, of course, in Indian music. Sometimes from a computer point of view, one hears of thousands, but there are certain basic ragas with different numbers of notes, ranging, I understand, from 5 to a maximum of 12 notes in a raga.
Yes, you know, Indian music can be divided by two main categories, ragas and talas. Ragas, mainly there are six ragas. Ragas is masculine gender and ragini is feminine gender. There are main six ragas, and each raga, they have got six wives, so it is altogether 36 raginis, and the children and grandchildren, you know, it has been several thousand
classified and a real family system.
Exactly. But actually there are main six ragas are masculine gender raga, male, and 36 female raginis.
And many of these ragas, of course, are suited to particular times in the day.
Yes, there are morning ragas, afternoon ragas, evening ragas, late evening, and night ragas, dead night ragas. I mean, in India, till we get the sunlight, up to 4:30 or 5 o'clock, we consider is at next day. So there are some ragas which is played after 12 to dawn. I mean, before the morning light comes.
Mm-hmm.
So there are early morning raga also, and also there are some seasonal ragas like spring ragas, rainy day ragas, autumn ragas, also some festival ragas like in India it is called Holi or color festival. So there are different type of ragas. And during day, afternoon, evening, late evening, ragas. But it's very difficult to define what is rag. That is a great point in our music. It's more or less difficult for me to explain actually what does it mean. In Western world, many people they mistake it by thinking raga, a scale, or just a tune, or just a melody. But it is not actually that. It is something more, because there are 10 scales in North Indian music, but several thousand ragas have been derived from these scales. So, scale is not all. It is said in our old Sanskrit language, Jo ranjayati iti raga. That means that combination of notes which colors your mind or which brings out the emotion and feelings of your mind is called rag. Word meaning of rag is color. So it is not only some permutation and combination of notes, but also there is some feelings, and it must color your mind or it must touch your heart. Not one single note, but also just some combination of phrase or notes must touch your heart. So it's very difficult to define what is raga.
In other words, a particular raga to you or to a musician who has learnt this is not, as you say, a collection of notes. It's something which you have learnt traditionally. It has particular moods connected with it.
Yes.
And a particular time of the day or season.
No, in the beginning of our training, we must learn some fixed composition on a rag. Everything fixed, and we practice on it for several years, minimum 5 years. After practicing different side and technique and different fixed composition of a rag for several years, then we gradually start improvisation on this rag. That is also in front of our teacher. He constantly guides us how to improvise and in which way and maintaining what discipline. Then, so after learning fixed methods and compositions for several years, minimum 8 to 10 years, then we start improvising on it. That is also in front of our teacher. Then gradually we improvise it and we come to know how to improvise a raga.
Now I'd like to go back to the particular things in a raga which mean something to you. For instance, a morning raga and an evening raga. Is there always a use of notes which differs a morning raga from an evening raga?
You know,
or is that generalizing too much?
It is, such as Western music, Do, Re, Mi, Fa, Sol, La, Si, our notes are called Sa, Re, Ga, Ma, Pa, Dha, Ni. These are the main 7 notes. Sa is considered as infinite. Second note, Re, is sorrow. Third note, Ga, is peace. Fourth note, Ma, is erotic. Fifth note, Pa, that is joy. Sixth note, Dha, is disgusting. And seventh note, Ni, is tranquil or peace. So it expresses these, each notes, 7 notes, they have got different meaning. So first thing, morning and evening rag, the difference is like that. Morning, sun rises from the infinite. So, infinite we considered is our tonic or sa. So the notes, it comes very nice way and straight way and with full energetic. So in the morning raga, the second, third note comes from sa or infinite. You know, it is just like the sun is rising from the infinite with new energy, beginning a new day. So more that, I mean, the sun comes up in the afternoon. So that is full energy and with full vigor. So the same way our notes are used in the morning ragas and in afternoon ragas. Morning is considered as the childhood, afternoon, youth, evening, old age. So in the evening raga, the same thing, the sun is setting in the infinite. So the notes are as if they are falling down on the lap of infinite, the sa. So the second or third notes, it used in such a way, in such a soft and tender way, as if the sun is going to take his rest in the infinite, in the lap of infinite. So the evening notes, if ragas, evening ragas, the notes are used in such a way that it wants to take rest in the lap of infinite. So it has got little more tender and soft in the evening raga.
Could you demonstrate the difference between those?
Yes, now I'll try. These are the three notes. There are scales in the morning. We have got five morning scales and five evening scales. So in one morning scale, like vairo, tat or scale, these three notes are used. And these same three notes are used in one of the evening scale or tat named purvi tat or scale. So in the morning, these notes are used like this way. Morning style, morning scale. The same notes are used in the evening scale, but little bit softer way. This second note, the second note, it is in the morning raga, it is goes straight from infinite or sa. Whereas in the evening, the same notes. The second note, it always wants to take rest in the lap of infinite. So it is used in more tender way. You know, I think everybody knows it very nicely that there are difference between morning prayer and evening prayer. Morning prayer, when a life is started, so it is something else. The day is starting or beginning. In the evening, when you are an old, so that time you want to think in a peaceful atmosphere what you have done throughout your life, what good, what bad. So naturally that time, as if you are speculating or calculating your good side and bad side. So there is difference between morning prayer and evening prayer. So the until unless you hear a full rag, I think for a Westerner it's difficult to feel how it is used.
Some of the other morning rags, like Todi, does this have a similar evening? Is there a similar raga in the evening with similar notes to Todi scale?
Yes, of course. You know, Todi, it's a morning raga, and Todi itself is a thaat or scale. But there are evening ragas which have been derived from this Todi thaat, such as Todi is a morning scale. Todi thaat. Second note, third note, sixth note are flat note, and fourth note is sharp note. It's a morning rag and a morning scale, but there is one rag called Multani. It's an evening melody, but Multani raga has been derived from Todi thaat. But the ascending notes like this. In ascending, second and sixth notes are not used. But in descending, all the notes are used. And as I told, as because this Multani is evening rag, so second note in descending, in ascending it is not used. In descending, the second notes, this note, it is used in so soft way, like, and sixth note also. Whereas the Todi thaat, this raga is derived from Todi thaat. In Todi morning, Second note is used like this way, straight.
Very bold.
Very bold.
Yes.
It is very bold. So this is, technically you can say this is a little bit, it's a type of difference, but you know, it's all comes from feelings, colors, emotions, you know. So notes, that is a mechanical things, but you have to put your own color and feelings in it. So then only it becomes a complete picture and it hits your strings of the heart.
Well, for instance, rag todi, what that particular rag, or what moods, what does this mean to you?
Music is an abstract of all arts, you know.
I realize it's extremely difficult to put it into
extremely
words.
Extremely difficult. You know, where words end, music starts. Naturally, it's very difficult to say. But in India, I think there are some very old paintings during Mughal period, I mean 16th century, 17th century. You will see many pictures in our museum in India where they have painted a picture of raga or raginis. But I am sure it is just an artist's impression on hearing a raga, nothing else.
Yes.
There cannot be any...
Of rag todi, for instance.
Exactly. Todi, it is said, it's a morning raga, and particularly it is a very favorite ragas of the deer.
Yes, there are pictures of a deer coming to a young maiden.
Yes, young maiden, actually she is crying and singing this raga. She is singing this raga for her beloved. Pathos. So the deer is coming, just hearing her song, which is based on this raga todi. It's all right. Even for some reason, it is an artist's impression. That's all. But ultimately, there cannot be any true and picture of a particular raga. It is all abstract.
Are there any devotion, any ragas which you associate with devotional songs which you've learnt as music? Are there particular ragas which are, for instance, rag Shankara, does that mean something devotionally to you?
Yes.
It is the name of the Lord Shiva, but does it? How much further does that go?
There are some ragas for devotions. Multani, just now I have played, it is also, mood is devotion. But love and devotion for the Supreme Soul, that is the basis of Indian music, you can say. Because, of course, we believe in 9 moods, such as erotic, comic, disgusting, frightful, tranquil, some like that, but joy, fearful, like that. There are 9 altogether. It's all right, but still, ultimately, you know, it's a, particularly the beginning portion of Indian music, that alap, that is just a like prayer or a cry for the Supreme Soul or for the realization of human beings, something like that. But raga like Shankara, it has been named in one of our deity, God, Shiva. And this raga, Multani, the mood is based on devotion.
And then another aspect which seems very evident to the more heroic or ragas. Again, you mentioned that certain notes in the scale are concerned with particular ragas. Does that mean that note will be stressed? It isn't a closed system, of course. I understand that when the particular note in the sariga is concerned with a particular mood, does that always come out in a raga? That a raga with, obviously it can't, because there are so many ragas with different notes. It can't always be that the note connected with peace isn't always.
Yes. Just now I have told you, suppose the third note, or that sariga, the third note, ga, it expresses the peace. So mostly in the evening ragas, ga is our vadi note, or the most important note in the melodic structure or rag.
So this does hold true for most of the ragas.
Yes.
But not for all of them?
No, but mostly, all these raga forms or this melodic structure, it has been based on this, such as the fourth note. This is the fourth note. It depicts the erotic, or we call it sringar. So this raga is mostly, generally it is not a vadi note or most important note to develop in the morning. Mostly in the late evening raga, you will find this note is very important to develop in the melodic structure. So there is some connection with the notes in making a melodic structure. Such as, now I will play one thaat. It's called Marwa thaat. But Marwa thaat is quite soft, but Marwa rag itself, that is considered as devotion and heroic. Marwa thaat is the fifth note in Marwa rag, it is not used. It expresses the joy. So it is not used in rag Marwa. Marwa rag, ascending and descending notes. And sixth note, it expresses disgusting, and this is the disgusting and heroic. This sixth note is the vadi note of Marwa. So definitely when we develop a raga, naturally mood is there, of course. So in developing the notes, once they feel the mood or emotion or the basic color of this rag, it affects on the minds of the listeners.
Thank you. You've been listening to Pandit Nikhil Banerjee, sitarist, who will be in concert this Saturday night at the Berkeley Little Theatre, accompanied by Pandit Mahapurush Mishra on the tabla. The concert begins at 8:30 p.m. and is sponsored by KPFA and the American Society for Eastern Arts.